Hello and welcome to the Django Celery Mastery course. Just a quick reminder, if you like this course and would like to access the source code and more, you can access this course on Udemy. The link to the course, which should provide the best price, is in the video description. Right, so next up we have the Celery Task Consumer, also known as Workers or the Worker. So these are components responsible for executing the tasks that are produced by the task producers. They form the backbone of the Celery architecture and play obviously a crucial role in distributed task processing. So we need to think about workers as independent processes that listen to the message broker for incoming tasks. When the task is received, the worker retrieves it from the message queue and then performs the assigned operation. So this then potentially produces some sort of result, which can then be sent back to the message provider for further processing. So these workers, as I've described before, they can be distributed across multiple machines or run on separate processes within the same machine to handle tasks concurrently and be scalable. Now, workers are designed to be highly available and fault tolerant, ensuring that tasks are processed reliably, and efficiently. So they communicate with the message broker, report task status, they handle task prioritization, and support various advanced features, which we'll explore in this course, including task routing, error handling, and retry mechanisms. Now, building the worker can take a little bit of thinking here. So let's imagine that we are building a Django application. Now, the types of tasks that we want to offload to the Celery worker, they may be Django-like tasks, in which case the worker will have to be configured to be able to process that task as expected. And that may mean that we have to set up Django or a Django environment and configure it to make it available to resources that are similar to the actual application that are coming from this message provider. Now, if you're just starting up utilizing Celery, then this can be a good type of process to go through to begin with, because it's just going to mean that whenever we make anything in Django, it's going to be copied across to the Celery worker. Because one of the other big considerations to consider is the fact that the message provider and the Celery worker, they're going to both need to know about the same tasks. So task distribution or task management in terms of making it available to all the workers and message providers and making sure that the code is both up to date and distributed to these different resources is going to be important. And there are different strategies for that, but we're just going to simplify this to begin with. We will work from that point. We're going to simply now just really copy what we've done with building the Django instance, and we're going to turn that into a Celery worker.